Hi, this is Luke from GuideToMyJailbreak.com, and today I'm going to be showing you how to restore your iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch in iTunes. Say you want to get your device repaired at the Apple Store, but we don't recommend you take it in there with it jailbroken because they could possibly void your warranty, so the easy thing to do is just to restore it beforehand. It's pretty simple. There's a few things you want to note, though. The first thing is you want to make sure that you transfer all your purchased applications to your computer. So to do that, go ahead and right-click on your device, and then click Transfer Purchases. This will take a few seconds to transfer your apps. Another thing you want to make sure to do is to sync your device. So go ahead and click that sync button, and that will back up your device as well. The next thing you want to grab is your photos. We're going to show you how to do it with a Mac or a PC. We're Mac fans, so Mac's up first. If you have a PC, go ahead and skip the Mac part to the PC part. If you're on a Mac, go ahead and minimize iTunes. Click on the Spotlight button. Type in Image Capture, and then click Enter. Okay, so from here you can import your photos. Go ahead and go down to Import 2, and then click Other, and then click Desktop. And then you can create a new folder and name it whatever you want to. Then click Choose, then just click Import All. And then you'll see those check marks, and that means that the pictures have been imported successfully. Now if you go to your desktop, you'll see that the pictures are there. Okay, so now it's Windows' turn. The process is relatively the same for most versions of Windows, but for this example, I'm going to be using Windows XP. When you plug in your device, this window should pop up. If it doesn't, I explain how to get to it later. Once the window pops up, go ahead and click Next, and then select the pictures that you want to download to your computer. Then click Next, and then you can choose where you want the pictures to download to. So click on Browse, and then for me, I'm going to click Desktop, and then I'm going to create a new folder. You can name it, and then just click OK. Then click Next, and now you'll see another window that shows you that the pictures are being imported. You can check Nothing and then click Next. Then just click Finish and you're done. And here you'll see the pictures have been downloaded onto your computer. If that pop-up didn't originally pop up for you, go ahead and click on Start, My Computer, then double-click on your Apple iPod or iPhone or iPad. And then you'll see the pictures right there. So just select them and then just drag them to your desktop. And you'll see that they're transferring right now. When that's done, they're on your computer and you're ready to go back to iTunes. Okay, so the next step is to open back up iTunes and then check your firmware. You can do that by checking next to Software Version. You'll see mine is 4.3.3. If you look next to the button that says Update, if it says a newer version of the iPod, iPhone, or iPad software is available, and then it'll say, you know, whatever the software number is. If you look below this video, you'll be able to see whether that new version is jailbreakable. If it's not, then you'll need to restore to the same version that you are currently on. For a step-by-step video of doing that, check out the link below this video. Just note, if you restore to the newest version and it's not jailbreakable, then you won't be able to jailbreak once you restore. And it's a little bit difficult to go back to the version you have right now from the newer version. So just check out the link below to restore the same version you're on. If your device isn't going to be updating, or the update can be jailbroken, or you just don't care about jailbreaking anymore and you just want to get rid of it, then just go ahead and hit that restore button. If you're not on the newest firmware, it'll ask you to update. Just reminding you, if this firmware can't be jailbroken, then you'll be stuck without a jailbreak until the next jailbreak comes out. Okay, so if you're going to restore, just click Next and then Agree. The firmware will download to your computer and then it'll automatically restore your device. After your device has been restored, you're done. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching.